your first fighter, making her way to the blue corner. This fighter is 27 years of age and weighing in 66 kilograms. He hails from Sheffield and fights out of Sheffield Shoot Fighters and has a record of 4 wins and 1 loss. In the blue corner, Musa the Savage Christian.
Good evening, fight fans, and welcome to Cage Steel 24 here at Doncaster Dome. Next up, we have Musa Christian, age 27. He's fighting our Sheffield Shoot Fighters. He is from Sheffield. His fight record is 4-1. Commentating tonight, you got myself, Nico Joker, joining me, cage side, Wayne McKenna. Good evening, Wayne.
Good evening, Nico. Good to have you with us tonight. Yeah, Sheffield Shoot Fighters always bring tough fighters. They know the game. They come here to bang. It's good to watch, Nico.
Yeah, absolutely. Musa predicted that. Basically, he said his prediction is to dominate the fight with ground and pound and finish them. We'll see if he can pull that off.
And thanks, guys, if you're watching us live on our pay-per-view. Keep an eye out on social media for all the up-and-coming events and offers.
Yeah, this is Moose's second appearance on the show. We last saw him in July against Jordan, Sheffield Arena.
And his opponent is 22 years of age. He's hitting 66.1 kilograms. He's first in Doncaster. That puts out an ABT. And has a record of 2 wins, 1 loss. In the right corner, Thomas Quinn!
Next up, we have Thomas Quinn.
Thomas, 22 years old, fights out of ABT Leeds. He hails from Doncaster, and he's got a fight record of 2 wins, 1 loss. His prediction, we spoke to him earlier, he's looking to win via a stoppage. We've seen Thomas twice before here at Cage Steel. His first time he had a dominant win over his opponent with a technical knockout. Last year we saw him take on Jordan Mayer where things didn't go to plan. But he's looking to make a difference here tonight.
Yeah, Thomas head coach Danny Mitchelton, who will be fighting tonight, boxing. So if you bought the pay-per-view already, good evening, guys. I hope you're enjoying the show. Your referee tonight, Craig Lawrence, getting the action on the way.
So Musa Christian is in the grey shorts. And Thomas Quinn is in the black shorts. This fight showed you for 3 3-minute rounds.
Oh, beautiful takedown by Christian. Now he's in half guard. He's got a great body lock there.
We've landed over in the red corner, that's the AVT corner. So they'll be giving instructions to Thomas Quinn.
Yeah, Thomas really needs to try and get up. But Christian's working nicely there, chipping away basically, just doing enough work so he doesn't get stood up. As you can see, basically, Thomas has got a beautiful knee shield there. He needs to get, he's got that left underhook, he needs to follow that left underhook. As you can see, Christian shut that down with a whizzer.
We know since Moose's last been here at Cage Steel, he's been entering loads of grappling competitions, stepping up his game in the grappling side and in the ground game. And we can see it here tonight, straight in with an aggressive takedown.
Yeah, great start for Christian there, basically. This fight brought to you by One Click Print. Check them out, guys. Thomas is working really hard to get up, but I tell you what, fantastic pressure by Christian there. He's staying low, he's not looking to push and let shots go. He's trying to maintain, trying to flatten Thomas down.
What advice would you give Quinn here, Nico?
Quinn is doing his job, basically. He's doing it fantastic. He's got a nice half guard. I think it's a great position to be, half guard. But personally, I think it's better than being in mount sometimes as well. But Thomas got a beautiful left shield. All Christian needs to do is just maintain this position, keep chipping away so the referee doesn't stand it up. And he'll run away with his first round. Thomas is doing really well, not taking too much damage though, as you can see. He's trying to stuff the head away. But he's too much pressure from Christian at the moment.
Closing seconds of the first round.
There you go, first round over. Let's see, both guys will be getting some advice from their corners.
See Sam Bolt there in the corner from Sheffield Shoot Fighters.
Yes.
Fought on our big show last year, this year actually, at the Fly DSA Arena.
Yes, Sam Bolt, great fighter himself. Now focusing on coaching as well. Musa has been very active though since his last fight on Cage Steel. He's done quite a few grappling competitions.
That needs to say that stop people going round.
All right. Seconds out, round two. There you go, Craig Lawrence is about to get this going. Thomas is going to try to avoid the takedown, but straight away gets put on his back by Christian.
Yeah, bulldozed over there by Christian.
I think Christian had one thing planned, and that's to take him down straight away.
Yeah, ain't nobody stopping him with that one.
Is that a sign he didn't want to do anything with it, Thomas striking? At the moment, he's on Thomas' guard.
Craig Lawrence, our referee, keeping an eye on the action.
Don't forget to follow Cage Steel on social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Check Cage Steel website out, www.cagesteel.co.uk. Great work by Christian, putting a lot of pressure on Thomas.
Yeah, chipping away with those little jabs to the body.
Thomas is 22 years old and Christian is 27 years old. This fight brought to you by One Click Print. One Click Print. Check them out. Thomas is doing really well. He's got his right foot on his hip. Is he looking for maybe a Kamara? But the head is in the same side. Needs to push the head to the side. But I think Christian's aware of it. Tried to look for butterfly. Beautiful. He needs to push on there now.
Well inside the second round. Guys, if you're watching on our pay-per-view, thank you.
He's looking for a Kamara there, but Christian is aware of it. Basically, straight away pulls it out. He's just maintaining half guard. He's not looking to like get mount or anything like that. He's just sitting there in half guard, chipping away. And he's working enough not to get stood up, so that's all he can do. Christian seems to be looking for a guillotine there, but he's trying to maintain, trying to make sure he keeps Thomas down. There you go, round two's over. And basically, what would you say when that round?
Again, it was all on the floor action. It was a grappling. All the subtle movements moving around on the floor. Did we see anyone trying to finish the fight? There were some attempts at submissions. We'll have to see how it clears up.
Yeah, Thomas is trying to look underneath. You know, it's quite hard. To be fair, Christian is not giving him much space. So Thomas underneath, we're trying to look for Kamara, trying to look for sweeps, trying to get up. But you can't take anything away from Christian. He did a fantastic job keeping pressure all the time, and he put him on his back within 5 seconds. So let's see if Thomas can come out on the third round and stop his takedown. Maybe get a takedown of his own.
That's it. We will see a takedown attempt from Christian in the third round, I'm sure of it.
Your matchmaker tonight here at Cage Steel, and every Cage Steel, is Danny Mitchell, who'll be fighting tonight later on. Your promoter is Dominic Gibbs. What an amazing job he's done with Cage Steel. I read some of his stories. He said basically he left a council job to basically just take over Cage Steel.
There we see the takedown. And he gets it.
Look at that head control, Wayne, though. Beautiful head control, yeah. Right where he should be. That's a nightmare, so he's doing a great job.
Yeah, if you're on the receiving end, you've got someone's head.
Again, he just lands on half guard. He's not looking to land on guard, mount, anything. Half guard, happy days. He strapped his arm with his knee.
Yeah, he's trying the same again to lock that arm and get the strike in.
Yeah, basically talking to Musa, he's been travelling around the country a lot, trying to improve his game as much as he can, entering grappling competitions. And you can tell basically with his takedowns, great takedowns, every single round put Thomas on his back. It looks like he's going to be 5-1 tonight. It'd be interesting to see where he goes, whether he has more amateur fights, whether he decides to turn pro.
Yeah, I think he really has come here tonight to try out his grappling. He's done these competitions. He's going to try it in the MMA game, see how it goes on. And it's worked for him tonight. He's had no problems with the takedowns. He's got no problem with the control on the ground.
Yeah, he's keeping positions. He's doing really well. You've got Thomas there trying to butterfly guard, but it's very hard when your head is against the cage. Thomas done really well, though. He's kept the half guard. He's not letting pass. Christian is not dominating him. He's just keeping great pressure on top. Beautiful work. Well, if I was Thomas right now, I would be aiming to get up as soon as I can. Oh, look at that. Christian is in mound. He's going to let some shots go. He needs to posture. If I was Christian, try and posture as much as he can. Take nothing away from Thomas, though. Look, he's controlling his posture. He's doing an absolute great job. He's doing enough.
Final not seconds of the third round.
Not taking any damage.
There we have it.
Great fight.
Nice show of respect.
Which way would you go in?
I can only go one way, really, Nico. Musa Christian. Takedowns every round. Stayed dominant on the ground. Yeah. Brought the fight his way.
Totally agree. You can see Sam Bolden there. He walked in smiling. Sam knows that basically Christian won this fight.